guys, thank you so much for joining me today. My name is Roxette, and today's topic is about the challenges I've faced so far living in Germany as a black person.
Gumana nanjye niyo waba ufite aho kujya mbwira mutima nibyo nibwira.
And I've been living in Germany for 10 years now, and I can vividly remember the first time I came here. So even if you learn some little basic languages in your country, but when you come here, it's totally different because everybody speaks so fast and you don't even understand anything. So the first challenge I had was the language barrier, because people understand that you're new and they try to speak slowly, maybe the first few sentences, and afterwards they're just speaking too fast, you can't understand. So language barrier is a great difficulty. So I'd advise you guys, as soon as you get to Germany, just look for the nearest language school, enroll and start learning, because you need the German language for you to stay in Germany and have a peaceful, smooth start. Another difficulty that not only me but very many foreigners face in Germany is finding homes and apartments is very difficult, because there are very many people, there's a lot of people living in Germany, and almost everybody has their own homes or apartments, and the teenagers get out of their parents' places and move to their own apartments. So you find very many people living alone in Germany. That makes it very difficult to find a home. But the difficulty as a foreigner comes, for example, with your name. Like, I have an African name, so when you apply for an apartment, they definitely, the first thing they see is then your name, and they already think, okay, this is a foreigner, how are we gonna get along together? Do they understand the language? Are they even able to pay me the money that I want? So most probably they always take the Germans first, and you're as a foreigner, or because of your name, they won't even call you to tell you, okay, you've got a place or not. So having a foreign name and looking for an apartment is very difficult. So most of the time, as I started making friends, I used to look for German friends who can help me apply for an apartment, because on my own I couldn't have found a better place to stay. Another difficulty is that in Germany there's a lot of paperwork, and the institution or the system is kind of connected, that for example when you want some registration because of you've moved into a new place and they want some document from you, and if you don't have this document, you can say, okay, let me just leave this part now, take care of the other part, and when I get this document, I can go back to the office and register or whatever you want to do there. But mostly that's not the case, because if you go somewhere else to do something different, they're going to ask you about this document that they ask you somewhere else. So, and mostly these papers are just like from childhood. Maybe they want your birth certificate, or they want something that proves, for example, if you want to get married, they'll ask you for something like a certificate that shows that you were never married in Kenya. So the paperwork is enormous, and you'll always have to finish with this institution first, and then when you're done with it, go to the next one. So just be ready. When you're planning to come to Germany, carry all your documents you have, so that you don't have the stress of calling back home and asking if they can send you, and then they send it and it is the wrong one. So to avoid that stress, carry everything you that identifies with yourself. Another challenge in Germany is that mostly in Germany, on Sundays and special holidays, everything is closed, apart from maybe restaurants, but everything is totally closed. And as an African, I'm used to it that on Sundays is the time of getting together, doing things with friends, but that's not the case in Germany. And on special holidays, you have to respect the peace and you don't disturb the neighbors around. If you don't have families and friends, then it's going to be difficult, because you have to look how you're going to have a nice time on the weekend. So another challenge that I face mostly is because I don't have my family around. So now that I have children, it makes it so difficult to find somebody to take care of your children, because maybe you want to run groceries or meet with a friend for a coffee. This makes it really difficult because here you can't just tell your neighbor, hey, can you please take care of my kids? I'm going out for. It is very difficult. So it's either you look for a babysitter, which is very expensive, or ask your friends. If you have friends that you can trust with your kids, then that's the best or the best thing to do. Another challenge I faced was when I was looking for a job. First, when I got here, I wanted to do the nursing course, and I applied for a nursing school, and the boss just told me on my face that, I'm sorry, I can't give you an answer right now. I have to make sure that all the German students or the German applicants have gotten the job, and then if there's still vacancies, then I can consider you. So that really broke my heart and made me feel like I'm not so important, you know. So it is very difficult when you're looking for a good job, like good paying jobs. Mostly they consider employing the Germans first, and when you're not lucky, you'll either have to move somewhere else and look for the same job, or you have to apply for a job where there's scarcity, a shortage of personnel. So this part that I'm going to talk about is about racism. In Germany, people don't like talking about racism a lot. It's a delicate issue. So I've experienced racism at work, but mostly it's the older generation. So I really don't know how exactly also to talk about this issue, because no one feels free to talk about it, but I'm just going to express what I've faced so far. Sometimes when I'm a nurse, so like when I get to a room, maybe after 4 days off, and you come back and people just look at you like, okay, so what do you want from me? Can you please send me a white nurse or a German nurse, because I can't start dealing with you or something? Or you guys can remember around 2015, there were a lot of refugees coming from Syria and Afghanistan. And then I just went to a room, beginning my shift, and you go inside and somebody's like, hello, do you come from Syria or Afghanistan? So people just look at you and they feel like, okay, you're a refugee, you want something from me. You know, that's just a feeling that makes you really uncomfortable. And as much as it is a social work and you want to help the person, but you already feel like, okay, this guy is just slamming the door on my face, doesn't need me, doesn't want me to help them because they think I have no idea or something. So this always made me feel pressured to outstand the others. You want to do better, you want people to accept you the way you are, and that is just pressure for nothing. As long as you know you are in the right place, you know what you're doing, you don't need to feel any you don't need to feel bad or feel like you're in the wrong place. Mostly it is the older generation that show some habits of racism to me, I can say. I usually just stand on the ground and just say, okay, my name is this and this, and today I'm the nurse in charge, I'm going to take care of you. And if the patient is not happy with me as the nurse, I'll just inform my boss, and then maybe they can transfer the patient to another room, or I can just go and take care of other patients, because I try to avoid stress as much as possible. But mostly it is not easy. Another challenge that I've faced mostly is from last year when I had my babies. And I always have this feeling that wherever I walk, everywhere, strolling with my kids or playing with them on the playground outside, that I feel like people are just observing me. And sometimes they even talk about you, thinking that you don't understand their language. Last year when the government announced that all families with children are going to get the 300 euros bonus, that is when I started experiencing a lot of pressure, I can say, because anytime I would go with my children for a stroll in the park, people just observe you. At one point, even an elderly lady stopped me and told me, why can't you just go back to work? Why do you misuse the child benefits and just make the black people in Germany just want to make children because of the child benefits, and not, they don't like going to work? So you're like, seriously? I didn't even know that the government is going to make such rules for kids, so I feel it's so unfair. And then just like almost the same week, another day, I was also going for a walk, and then I stopped at a zebra crossing, but there were also traffic lights, so I have to wait until the light for me are green so that I can go with my stroller. And then a car stopped, and when the guy stopped, he hooked, rolled down the windows and told me, go back to work or go back to Africa. So it really breaks my heart, because some Germans, the older ones, think that when you have children as a black person, you have children because you don't want to go to work, because you just want to sit at home and make money. But it's not true, because I have been working ever since I got to Germany, and I've been living here for 10 years. If that was the case, then I could be having more than 10 children now. So such things really make me mad, and it's unfortunate that at this time I didn't know how to react to this situation. But next time when something like that happens to me, I'm definitely going to record the number plate and report the case to the police, because I feel sometimes scared for my children, because I ask myself, how are my children going to grow up in this country? Because they are black, but they are Germans. My children have the German nationality, but having a German nationality doesn't make you a German, because that's what the people are trying to prove to me. And I find that really heartbreaking. Well, at one point, I was also trying to cross a road, and on one side, the cars had already stopped, but as I was about to cross the road, another car just came, and it really got me scared that I decided that I'm not going to cross a road until all cars have stopped or until there's no cars on the road. Another challenge I faced is that going to discos in Germany is really difficult when you're a black person. And the worst thing is that you see on the website the post black music playing on Friday or Saturday, and you get happy because at least you're going to have some African rhythm or some hip-hop. And then when you get there, they tell you you can't go in, but they don't give you a reason why you can't go in. So you stand there, you see people coming and going in, but they tell you no, you can't get in. So that's really heartbreaking, because I think they don't even need to say black music if they don't like black people. Yes, yeah, so since that happened quite a lot of time, I just decided, okay, I'm going to create my own disco at home, invite my friends, make cocktails and just have fun, and it's really working. So guys, that's what I was going to talk to you about today. I hope you enjoyed the content. Let me know what you think in the comments down. And if you guys have experienced the same thing or almost the same thing, please let me know so we can find a solution to it. Thank you so much. See you next time. And guys, please don't forget to subscribe, comment, and share. Thank you so much.